Okay, now it is 12:04, so I'm going to start today's session. My voice is audible to all? If my voice is audible, then please type Y. Okay. So warm good afternoon, warm and good afternoon to everyone. Now I am welcome you all in this SYBED and in the first session of course 201. Today I'm here to give you orientation about the course 201. The title of the course is Quality and Management of School Education. I'm going to repeat the title, Quality and Management of School Education. I have one query. See, if you want to get good marks in the final examination, then what are we supposed to do? Just type your answer in one or two words in the chat box. Okay, only study is the option. Or the systematic study. Meenal Pagar, please unmute your audios. Deepa. Meenal Pagar, she is saying the study is most important thing to get good marks in the final examination. I want some other responses. Is hard work is needed? If yes, then type yes. Planned preparation, okay. Meenal is saying planned preparation. Hard work is also needed, study is needed. But my dear friends, I would like to tell you, for getting good marks in the final examination, we have to study planned. But before that, we have to study deep an entire syllabus of the particular paper and the question paper pattern. So today I'm here to give you orientation about the course 201. Okay, who will tell me? Just see, this is not a face-to-face classroom interaction. So we will have only the virtual interactions here. So for that, we can use chat box. Okay, who will tell me the title of the course 201? See, I'm not going to repeat, but what happened at the end of the academic year also, the students, they are not able to tell or even write name of the paper in the final examination. Okay, Meenal Pagare is saying quality and management of school education. Shubhangi Afre, she is also saying quality and management of school. Very good. Thank you, dear. So title of course 201 is Quality and Management of School Education. Just see the title and tell me what are the keywords in that topic, in that name of the course 201. Do you find any keywords? Just type what kind of keywords you can see in the title of the paper. Just write in the chat box. Yes. I want quick responses from your side. Quality, management and education. Okay, very nice, very nice. Quality, management and education. Okay, we'll start with the first word, that is the quality. Most of the time, always you are saying, well, we want particular quality cloth, we want particular quality product. Then what do you mean by quality? Just type whatever things after hearing, after listening the word quality, whatever things comes in your mind, please tell me. Now I'm going to share slide, screen sharing. Okay. Is it visible to all? Yes, very good. Okay, we will start with the first word or first key concept, that is quality. Quality means what? Just type whatever things comes in your mind. Just type. What do you mean by quality? I want responses from your side. Quick responses. Okay, good word. I'm going to type good word here. Good word. Then standard. Quick understanding. Okay. Standard. Quick understanding. Anything else? Good word, standard, quick understanding. Quick understanding. Characteristic, fulfillment, improvement. Okay. Improvement. Special talent. What kind of special talent, Meenal? Special inner ability. Okay. Inner ability. Okay. First, tell me who will decide the quality? See, only the customer, he will decide the quality, and there are several parameters to decide the quality of particular product or particular service, isn't it? To able to communicate, to explain. Okay. To able to communicate, to explain. See, the key concept was quality, and your answers were good worth, standard, quick understanding. Some spelling mistake was there. Just try to understand. Understanding is more important. Improvement, special talent, inner ability. My dear friends, nowadays we are talking about the quality, not about the quantity. And quantity, we can say the particular thing is having quantity means whenever a particular thing is able to fulfill need of the customer, then and then only we can say that particular thing is having quality. Okay. I'm going to share the second presentation before you. Please unmute your audio. Okay. As you all know, we all are aware of problems faced by the existence. Citizens. Which in turn has lowered the efficiency of the education system. The desire to achieve higher standards, education depends on the quality. See, means you can see quality. We need to concentrate on the quality of the education. Just I raise the question, that is, what is quality? Now tell me, is there any relationship between quality and reputation? Is If your answer is yes, then please type. Okay. So when we can say the particular company or particular institution is the reputed institution. The quality maintenance, then you can say that particular institution or particular educational institution or company, that company is the reputed company or the institution, isn't it? For reputation, we can say the quality, reliability. Reliability, when there is a continuation in the quality, they can say, then we can say that there is a reliability. Again, the price, it should be affordable to the everyone, and the delivery, we can say the service, all things are important for the reputation. And in short, we can define the term quality, that is, if there is a meeting, it meets the customer's requirements, then we can say the particular thing, it can be product, it can be service, then it is says as quality. It is the ability of product and service to continue to meet the customer's requirement. Quality is also defined as, see, the another product exceeds the expectation again. Also, so what the teaching learning, it's a what's what kinds of whatever school or college is providing to the student in terms of material as well as human resources, in terms of quality, teaching, learning, everything comes under the process. And the services, it can be throughout the academic year, even after passing of the particular standard or after leaving the school or college, what kind of services particular institution is giving, that comes under the services. Okay.
Excuse quality, me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, sorry to interrupt, but we are not able to view the screen that you are sharing.
Okay, okay.
And your voice is breaking.
Thank you for your suggestion, dear.
Yeah.
Is it visible? Oh, now it is visible?
Yes, now
yes,
it is.
Ma'am.
It is visible. Okay. Quality is an abstract perception, but we can measure the quality in the quantitative term. See, there is a formula to measure the quality. See, the quality is equal to P upon E. P means what? P means performance, and E means expectations. So when you can say the particular thing is having quality, when the performance is higher than the expectations, then only we can say we are having quality, isn't it? There are different dimensions. It will disturb others also. There are different dimensions. I'm not going too deep in the dimensions of the quality. Okay. Mute your audio as a see, there are different dimensions of quality. Performance is the one dimension. Aesthetic means you can see the sundarta, the appearance should be good. Then the special features. Can anyone give me one example? You can unmute your audio and give me example of special features in terms of you can take example of anything. Can anyone tell me what will come under the special feature? Special feature means extra characteristics. See, here we can compare potato chips of two companies. Okay. Most of the time we prefer Balaji chips. Why we prefer Balaji chips? Because extra quantity of chips. The taste is good, but they are giving extra quantity. So can be a extra characteristics. We can say the special features of the Balaji wave. Then conformance, how well product and services conforms to customers expectations, means fulfillment of the customers expectations. Reliability, when there is a consistent perform the product or the service is reliable. Durability, particular product should be durable, means what? See, now you can think how these the dimensions they can applicable in the education field. Hello, my voice is clear. Hello, useful life product or service. See, this is related to the commerce field, but in terms of education, durability means what? Suppose I'm teaching particular concept by using lecture method. Okay, so the retention rate is maybe lower, but if I teach the same concept by using the activities, different activities, so the durability, or you can say the retention rate, it is the better. So that we can include under the durability. Perceived quality, indirect evaluation. Perceived quality, in short, we can say the repetition. Serviceability, the service after the sale. The service after the sale, it is related to the commerce field. But service, see, if any college or any institution, they are planning the alumni meet, and what kind of service they are giving to you, that comes under service ability. Okay. I think quality concept is clear to you. If the quality concept is clear to you, then please type yes. So I can move ahead. Please type yes if the quality concept is clear to you. Okay, Deepa, Asha, Meenakshi. Okay. Let's move to the next keyword, that is the management. So for that, I'm again going to share screen. Okay. Very famous word. Your particular friend, her management is not good. She is not good in planning. So most of the time we are using this word. To this word. If yes, then please type yes. I'm not able to see chat box, so can't see your responses. Yes. Are you familiar to this word management? Management means what? Nowadays, this concept or this keyword, it is applicable everywhere. Okay. So basically, from where this term came, this term, it came from the commerce background or commerce field. But now it is applicable in the education also. See, in the first unit, there is a concept of management. Do you think that only there is a single manager and he is handling each and everything in the institute? Is only the single person who is handling each and everything in the management or each and everything in the institution. My statement is right or wrong? If my statement is wrong, then please write W. Yes, Mansi is saying no, only manager, he is not responsible to handle all the responsibilities. It is a group work. Yes, yes, I'm wrong. Because communication, you can say. Yes, it's a teamwork. Yes. It is important, not even in the other sector, but in our home also, it is very important. Mansi, am I audible? Please unmute your audio and tell me audible or not. Or you can just write yes in the chat box. Mansi. Okay. So this term, it is that almost all the girls, they are married, I think. Am I right? Okay. So as a mother, as a daughter, Asha Hegde. Okay, thanks for reminding me, Asha. Now audible, Mansi, am I audible clearly? My voice is audible? Okay, okay. Thank you. Okay. So we have to play different roles. Role of a mother, role of a daughter, role of a daughter-in-law. So you have to play different roles. And you have to do different tasks at a time. Even you have to do our job, you have to do our household work. So in our daily life also, in every day, we have to manage different things together, right? So this is very nearer concept to our day-to-day life. But now this is applicable in the management, in the education. See, two concepts mean quality management. Where it should be, the quality management, it should be in the school education or quality of our course 201, quality and management of school education. I'm not going to give in detail in introduction about the management concept, because in the first unit we are having in detail. Okay. Then let's move towards the syllabus orientation. Course screen is visible to everyone. If it is visible, then please type yes. My screen is visible to everyone. No, Yogita? Okay, I will stop and I will share it again. Tell me now it is visible. Asha, yes. Okay, okay. Course 201, the title of the course is Quality and Management of School Education. Dear friends, it having total 4 credits and the total teaching hours or learning teaching hours are 64. See the marks, external 80 marks, internal 20 marks, and your final mark sheet you will get out of 100 marks. Okay. Credit system is what? See, total 4 units are there in the course 201, and each unit is having 1 credit. Even the number of hours, they are also divided by 4, means 64 by 4. Tell me the answer. by 4. Yes, it is 16. Very good. Sonali, null, it is 16. Means 16 hours are given for each unit and 1 credit is given for each unit. Okay. Okay. Who will tell me the difference between aim and objectives? Just type in one sentence. What is the difference between aim and objective? Aim is a step to reach towards the objective. Am I right or wrong? If I'm wrong, then type W. If I'm right, then type R. Aims, these are nothing but the steps to achieve the objectives. If I'm wrong, then type W. If I'm not wrong, if I'm right, then type R. No one is responding. My voice is clear to you? Yes. Okay, Swapnali is saying yes. I want some other responses. Right. Right. My dear friends, please repeat the question. Okay, I'm going to repeat this again. The aims are the different steps to reach towards the objectives. I'm going to repeat. Aims are the different steps to reach towards the objectives. DP guys saying wrong. Okay. Some students they are saying right, and some students objectives, they are the steps to reach towards the aim. Entire thing about the first use of the code. Yes, Asta, very nice. Aim is a broad term and objectives are specific statements of the steps we can say. So I can think you are wrong. Shivangi, aim is the broader vision and objectives are the small steps taken in correct decision. Yes, Shivangi, you're right. Thank you. See, let's see the objectives of the course. Objectives of the course are to enable the student teachers, means you people, okay, to enable the student teachers to understand the concept of management. I think there is no need by achieving objective you will reach towards our aim. Yes, Sonali, you are right. Background, lot of disturbances. See, some students, videos or videos, they are on. So it is disturbing us. Please mute your audios as well as videos. Clear to you? Pratima Kumari, I'm going to mute me. My clear voice. So here I'm going to mute you. Pratima, don't unmute again and again. Others are getting disturbance. Pooja, I'm going to mute you. Okay. Now I'm going to share my screen again. The actual syllabus orientation of course 201. Okay, is it visible to all? If it is visible to all, then please, one or two students, please type yes. So that I can move ahead. Okay, so Nali, thank you. See, objectives of the course, to enable to student teachers to understand the concept of management. The management, and you will come to know in the lecture. Then the second objective is understand the concept of quality and enlist the dimensions. See, I have told you some dimensions of the quality, and I think you clearly understand concept of quality. Can you tell me what are the dimensions of quality? If you remember dimensions, then please tell me what are the dimensions of quality. At least tell me one or two dimensions of the quality so that I can. The performance, very good, Padmaja. Yes. Some other responses. Special features, very good. Reliability, very good. Yes. Durability, very nice, Shubhangi. Okay. Means the quality, conformance, very nice, Padmaja. Means you clearly understood the concept of quality and dimensions. Okay. Then the next is understand the need and importance of school accreditation. Have you heard this word, that school accreditation, before? Understand the need and importance of school accreditation. Accreditation means what? If you have heard this word before, then please type yes. Or why? Accreditation means what? In Hindi or Marathi, you can say namankan. See, if you see your mark list, you can see gradation. Gradation is there. They are getting O grade, some they are getting A grade, some they are getting B grade. So that is the namankan that is related to the students. But here, the namankan or accreditation that is related to the school. Do you really think that it is necessary for all the schools? I'm going to repeat. Do you really think that school accreditation is really necessary? If yes, then please type yes. No, it is not necessary. The accreditation is see why school accreditation is necessary. We'll give one example. If we will not conduct any examination, then what will do? You study very hard, yes or no? Of course not. Yes, Shivangi is saying still she will do. That is very nice, Shivangi. Mansi, she is saying no. If we cancel all, please study hard. See, if I suddenly tag your first year exam, then what will happen? How many students they get? They get, I think really 20-30% students they. System is very, very, very important. The accreditation means what? Someone is doing examination of your school. My school is also going to give one some kind of examination. So that is nothing but the accreditation. And on the basis of accreditation, the gradation is given to the school. And the gradation itself defines the quality of the school. Isn't it understood, the school accreditation? If yes, then please type yes. Okay, Asta, yes. Mansi, she's also saying yes. Okay, okay. Thank you, thank you. Okay, we'll move ahead. Acquire knowledge, the concept and process of human resource management in the school education. See, if we see the resources, basically there are two kind of resources in every organization: material resources and the human resources. And to maintain the quality, there is a really need of human resource management. And one more term is there, that is human resource development. So can you give me any idea? So which kind of technique any organization can apply for human resource development? Just type in one or two words. See, that is nothing but the professional developments of the human resources, those who are working in the yes training. See, training now you're now also you are getting training. So what kind of training you are getting here? You're also getting teacher training. See, the teacher training is here, but the main difference is this is not in service training. This is pre-service training. But after going into job, if you are getting any kind of training, that is in service to administer. Yes, to administer any situation, you might have attended various online workshop, right? So that also comes under the professional development of the human resources. See, during this pandemic situation, I attended so many webinars, even the faculty development programs. So everything comes under. Shall I move ahead? Because only you are. Hello? Yes? Please unmute. I'm again.
Unmute.
I'm going to mute you.
Mute her, na? Unmute.
Archana Kulkarni, please mute yourself. Others are getting distraction. Okay, thank you. Structure resources responses very fastly. What do you mean by infrastructures? What comes under infrastructure? Just tell me in one word. I'm going to open your chat box. Infrastructure means what? What comes under infrastructure? Most of the time you are saying that particular school is not having proper infrastructure. Means what? Labs, okay. Amenities, what kind of amenities? Just elaborate it. Campus, yes. To make to enhance education. See, I'm telling only about the infrastructure, the things we can see with facilities, services. See, infrastructure means what? Even the classroom, it is infrastructure. Different kinds of lab, laboratories, libraries, canteen, parking, all these kind of things are comes under the infra. Yes, physical structure and facilities. Bhagyasri, organization means what? See, organization, it is totally different thing. This is not related to infrastructure. It is not infrastructure. Playground, yes, Sona. Fundamental facilities. Can you give me one example of fundamental facilities, Deepa? Fundamental facilities means what? Just type. Okay, let it be. I think you are very clear about the infrastructure facilities. Then the next is become familiar with the different types of school in India. State board, proper classroom. Yes, I'm going to move ahead. Familiar with the different types of school boards in India. SSC board, SSC and HSC, these are the together boards. So state level board, national level board and international level board. So this is also an objective to make you familiar about the different types of school boards in India. And the last objective, that is to authorities. There are different authorities. Some authorities are at state level, some authorities they are at national level. So objective number 8, you will learn this entire objective in the unit number 4 to understand administrative setup of government and functions of supportive authorities. I think this is our time is over. It's 12:45 now. Okay. I think the basic keywords now, it is very clear to you, the keywords as well as all the objectives of this course. If is it clear to you all? Students, please give your responses. Okay, thank you so much. I think we will start the detailed syllabus orientation in the second lecture. So with Thakur's permission, I will stop here because someone is waiting for the second lecture, right? The duration of my lecture was only 25 minutes for 12 to 12:45. So I'm going to stop here. Okay. So till today, bye-bye. Take care. Stay home. Stay safe. Thank you.
हेलो हेलो सर हेलो हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, मैं ऑडिबल?
यस मैम.
ओके ओके.
यस मैम.
थैंक यू.
Herika sir, please allow me for screen sharing. Hello, sir. Principal, sir. Hello, dear student. My screen is visible now.
Yes,
hello.
Ma'am.
Oh,
yes,
okay,
ma'am. Hello, dear student. You all are welcome in this my lecture. You all have entered in the second year, so I heartily congratulate to you. I'm sure you will do the same this year with the same enthusiasm as we did in the previous year. Today, hello. Today we are going to take the lecture of introduction of subject paper is a knowledge and curriculum and language across the curriculum. Paper code is 202. I am going to teach you this subject. So once again, I assisted Professor Darshana Pawar. Welcome to you in this lecture. First of all, I would like to make a request to you. If you have any doubts, any queries or questions, so Can you ask me at the end of the session? Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
The next is objectives. If you want to do something else, you have to decide its objective first. Because of objective are guide to you reach your destination with right path. Okay. So also same objective are given regarding the subject. This will also give the right direction to study. The first one is understand the source of generation of knowledge. Second objective is realize the interrelationship between knowledge, information, and skill in the present social context. Third one is understand the dimension of curriculum development. Fourth one is understand the social basis of framing curriculum. Number five is get acquainted. Just a minute. Get acquainted with the views of Indian thinkers on the social basis of framing curriculum. Objective number six is comprehend the concept and relevance of multilingualism in the Indian context. Number seven objective is get acquainted with the activity-based learning approaches. Objective number eight is realize the concept and relevance of language in learning. Objective number nine is become familiar with the strategy of developing language skill. The next is, in this subject, it consists of a four unit. The unit number one is knowledge and education. Unit number two is dimension of curriculum. Unit number three is a social basis of framing curriculum in education. Unit number four is language and curriculum. The next is our syllabus. Let's first look at the syllabus at one glance after we will see the summary of the unit. Okay. The first unit is knowledge and education. It is for one credit. 1.1 is data, knowledge, information, skill, and wisdom. 1.2 is a source and generation of knowledge. 1.3 is a modern child-centered education, learning through activity. 1.4 is a modern child-centered education, learning through discovery. 1.5 is a modern child-centered education, learning through dialogues. The second unit is a dimension of curriculum. It is also for one credit. 2.1 is a meaning, concept, and types of curriculum. 2.2 is a principle of curriculum development. 2.3 is a knowledge, curriculum, syllabus, and textbook. 2.4 is a development of curriculum, model of curriculum construction, Hilda Taba model, Taylor model. With respect to following points, A is the planning of curriculum, B is a curriculum design, C is a curriculum transaction. 2.5 is a National Curriculum Framework 2005. The unit number three is a social basis of framing curriculum in education. It is also for one credit. 3.1 is a value in the Indian Constitution and their reflection curriculum of secondary education. 3.2 is Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar's view on curriculum of secondary education. 3.3 is Mahatma Gandhi's view on curriculum of secondary education. 3.4 is Tagore's view on curriculum of secondary education. 3.5 is a multilingual context of education. Unit number 4 is a language and curriculum for 1 credit. 4.1 is a language, meaning home language and school language, standard language and dialects, foreign language. 4.2 is a Bullock report with reference to the concept of language across the curriculum. 4.3 is a using oral language in classroom learning. It consists of vocabulary, discussion, and questioning. 4.4 is a reading in different content area, reading strategies from different contexts, making connection between reading and presenting. It is our writing. 4.5 is a multilingualism, meaning and concept, important of multilingualism and catering to multilingualism in classroom. Okay. Now we can see the summary of this unit. In unit number 1, okay, the unit number 1 is a knowledge and curriculum. In this unit, point 1.1, have some concepts are given. First is a data. If you look at it that way, you know the concept of data. You are also use word data in our day-to-day life. We will see in this unit concept of data knowledge also. That's why we can learn these concepts, definition, meanings, objective, types of data, types of data sources. Like this way, that data concept is totally clear. In same way, the concept of knowledge, information, skill, and wisdom also need to explain. 1.2 is a source and generation of knowledge. Some of the major sources of knowledge are explained in this point. Also, this topic consists generation of knowledge. 1.3 is a modern child center education. Okay, in this topic we learn about what is child center education, child center education's merits, demerits, and also characteristics. In this topic, first is a learning through activity. In modern education system is based on activity, or we can say activity centered. This will provide knowledge and skill essential for leading a good life. We will also study the type of activities like a project method, learning through play. We will explain each concept completely when we conduct this lecture or conduct this unit. Second is learning through discovery. It is an active process of inquiry-based instruction. And you know the actual concept of discovery. So what is discovery? The discovery is nothing but the act of detecting something new or something previously unrecognized as a meaningful. In this topic, we will also learn principles of learning through discovery and its type. Third is a learning through dialogues. A dialogue is a very different from what we normally call discussion or a debate. We will see types of learning through dialogues, their advantages and disadvantages. Thus, we have briefly analyzed unit number 1. Now see unit number 2. The unit number 2 is a dimension of curriculum. In this unit, 2.1 is a curriculum. In this topic, we will study in depth analyze like what is curriculum, meaning of curriculum, some definition of curriculum, Also, we learn about aims of curriculum, objective of curriculum, types of curriculum. This is part of 2.1. The next is a 2.2. 2.2 is the principle of curriculum development. Is so 2.2 is a how the curriculum development process is implemented. We will review many such issue or concept in this topic. 2.3 is a knowledge, curriculum, syllabus and textbook. In this topic, we will discuss about their meaning, definition, difference between curriculum and syllabus. Also, we will discuss about types of curriculum. The next is a 2.4. Models of development of curriculum, models of curriculum constructions. So, dear student, each curriculum describes several and different approaches which reflect the developer's view of reality, philosophy, history, psychology, social issues, and also other impact. And every approach impacts on the design of the curriculum. In this topic, we will study about Hilda Tabar's curriculum development model, and second is the Ras Taylor curriculum development model. Both of them have discussed how to have good curriculum. Then last point is a 2.5. It is a National Curriculum Framework 2005. National Curriculum Framework 2005 is the fourth National Curriculum Framework published in 2005 by the National Council of Educational Research and Training, that is NCERT. The NCF, that is National Curriculum Framework 2005, is a several as the guidelines for syllabus, textbook, and teaching practices for schools in India. Okay, so let's learn more about this while teaching in this unit. Until then, keep download NCF. In this way, the second unit is completed. The third unit is social basis of framing curriculum in education. At the every outset of critical analysis of the Indian school education system reveals that it is largely of monolithic system, perpetual a kind of education which has resulted in the set of practices adopted for development of curriculum, syllabus, textbook, that is guided by the patterns and requirements of the examination system. In view of its importance to analysis whatever the exciting policy and curriculum framework facilities development. The next is a 3.1. In this topic, values in the Indian Constitution and their reflection in curriculum of secondary education. The Indian Constitution has certain core institutional value that constitute its spirit and expressed in various articles and provisions. The constitutional value are reflected in the entire constitution of India, but its preamble embodies the fundamental values and the philosophy on which the constitutional based. We can see the list of constitutional values. We will discuss constitutional values and their reflection in curriculum later while explain this unit. Before that, you have ready to a list of constitutional value and the meaning. The next point is 3.2. Views of Indian thinkers on school curriculum of secondary education. The Indian philosophers such as Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, Rabindranath Tagore, Mahatma Gandhi has made contribution in education. So we will learn in this unit their educational views on curriculum of secondary education. They are explain about student, teachers, teaching method, curriculum, syllabus, etc. The 3.5 is a multicultural context of education. So what is multicultural context? Multicultural context of education is nothing but the set of educational strategies development to assist teachers when responding to the many issues created by the rapidly changing demographic of their student. It provides students with knowledge about history, culture, contribution of diverse groups. We will also see in this topic principle of multicultural context of education, their advantages and disadvantages also. Now we can see the summary of unit number 4. Unit number 4 is a language and curriculum. Is a language. So what is language? So language is a form and mean of communication. It is a intimately related to human being since it is a universal and exclusive characteristics of man alone. It is the product of human mind and the vocal opportunities with its human being processes. This unit deals with the definition, nature, concept, meaning, functions of language. It is also consists of teaching language as a skill rather than knowledge subject, the role of language across the curriculum. The next is a home language and school language. India is a unique not only in the large number of languages as spoken here, but also in terms of a number and variety of languages families that represent in those languages. So we will learn in detail while conducting this unit. The next is a standard language and dialects. It is a sub point of this 4.1. So what is standard languages? A standard language is a language that is used in government, in the media, in school. So how standard language can impact on curriculum, we will see in this unit. The next one is a foreign language. The sum of about foreign language we will see in this topic. Also we see the two important parts of this topic. First is a foreign language education and ability. The second is a instrument for foreign language. Is a Bullock's reports of language across curriculum. Alan Bullock present this report on teaching of English. He was also represented principle of language across the curriculum. The Bullock reports listed 17 principal recommendation. We will study these details in our explanatory lecture. Now, 4.3 is using oral language in classroom learning. Oral language is often associated with vocabulary as the main component. However, in the broad definition, oral language consists of phonology, grammar, morphology, etc. Concepts are included in this topic. As well as we will see important of oral language, area of oral language, guidance for classroom questioning. 4.4 is a reading strategies for different content areas. Simply, the contents area reading in that a person needs to complete and understand in particular subject area, then how it is work, we will see in this topic. Also, some activities are given and also activities are given in this topic, and the all activities are very interesting. The next point is a 4.5, that is a multilingualism. We will see what is multilingualism, meaning of multilingualism, definition of multilingualism, important of multilingualism, and also type of multilingualism. In this way, we see all units summary. The reason for introducing the syllabus is that once all you hearing that, after you understand the scope of the subject. Got it? Okay. Then the next is a practical work. The previous information is about written paper. Now see the practical regarding information. The practical number one is a visit to SPPU Pune, DIET, MSCIT Pune for study of curriculum development process. Second is a comprehensive study of curriculum of different boards, that is SSC, ICSC, CBSC and IB. The third practical is a analysis of children literature and teacher's handbook in the context of knowledge, curriculum, language and society. Anyone. The fourth one is a presentation of subject content in the form of a summary, explanatory notes, prices, writing, the diagrammatic presentation. Okay. So dear student, in practical, you have three activities here. The first one is a any one of this practical. Okay, in this four practicals, you can you also do the only one practical. So the practical activities, there are three activities. First one is a any one of these four practicals. Second is a take the tutorial or MCQs. Third one is the preliminary exams. All these activities you want to do in practical session. So we will plan it later. Also, we decided about which practical we can do for these four practicals. Okay. I will guide you from time to time now how to practical do. Okay. The next one is a paper pattern. The paper pattern of first and second year are the same. It is 80-20 pattern, 80 marks for written and 20 for a practical. It include these three activity. Okay. Now we can see about paper pattern. The A is essay type, 4 question. Each questions carry 15 marks of the answer of the same are expected to be written in above 400 to 425 words each. In this section, all questions are compulsory and it is for 60 marks. Now, B is a short answer question which carry 5 marks should be answered is above in above 150 to 175 words each. And you attempt any 4 of these. So dear student, so the purpose of discussing the pattern is now that that you will study accordingly and you can do perfect preparation. And one important thing is, if you are possible, take the download of old question papers near you for the best practices. The next one is references. A list of references is also provided at the end of your syllabus. So now we shall stop here. And this is a end of this our lecture. So you have any queries or question, then ask me. And hope so you all have understood today's lecture. Thank you. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone can doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay.
No, ma'am.
Okay, then end this session.
Sure, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much, dear student.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.